Good morning, dear students. Welcome to the session on testing of hypothesis. As I understand, you are the students coming from social sciences background, and then I assume that you are very raw to statistics. You are just new to statistics and you don't know much about statistics. The session time is for 1 hour, and then it really makes it difficult for me to talk about testing of hypotheses in this allotted 1 hour. But then what the focus of the presentation is going to be is on understanding in simple language without using any much of statistical jargons or statistical terms, understanding what is meant by hypothesis and how it is going to relate to your area of study, and that too more specifically in research. So now before I start with hypothesis, it is very important for me to understand the background from where this hypothesis is going to be coming and how we are going to form this hypothesis. So that is where the entire crux of the research lies. So it's not testing which is very important. That is, we are going to have statistical tools and techniques, we have spaces, we have other softwares which we can be using to test this hypothesis. But more importantly is that, let's see how we are going to frame the hypothesis. Testing, we can take help of anyone who knows statistics, but in framing, there is no one to help you. So for the framing, it's you, the researcher, who is going to himself develop or formulate this hypothesis. So let's start from the basic of research. When I say from the basic of research, it starts right from this step one. In a sense, like when I say step one, that is a new researcher. Like say he has just got admission for the research course, that the fellowship program or the PhD program, and then he is very much new to the field of research, and he is not aware, like say, what topic he is going to select and from where he is going to select. He is basically stuck. Okay, so this is a phase, like say, everyone come across, and this is a phase wherein, like say, once you are able to tide over, like say, that makes your journey very simple, and it makes it very interesting. So you enjoy the next 3 to 4 years or 5 years, whatever the time separated by the university for doing the research, you will be just enjoying this journey of doing the research. So now when I say that we are going to start right from the basics, so basically basic means, like say, how do I select a topic? Now usually what happens is that when we take the admission for PhD, we take it in some streams. Like the streams could be like, it could be HRM, it could be finance, right? Or it could be marketing, or it could be say operations, it could be MIS, it could be like say XYZ field, right? So now I have got the admissions. Like say I want to do a PhD in commerce or in management, and my area is, let's say, marketing, right? But then what next? What in marketing? So that is a much more bigger question that needs to be answered by the student in consultation with the guide. Now in marketing, when I say, right, so marketing is as such a big field, it's a very broad area, and when I'm going to do the research, it has to be narrowed down. Now how is that I am going to narrow this field? That's from marketing. So basically I have to come out with the title of the research, and this title is going to define my objectives, this title is going to define my research methodology, and so on. So basically there is going to be a link which you are required to establish between your broad area, the title, the objectives of your research, the research design, and somewhere in between we are going to also have the hypothesis coming into play. So now let's see how we are going to narrow down this particular area. the easiest way is like say maybe so you have to read a good textbook in the field of marketing, maybe something like Philip Kotler. So this most of you might have read, maybe as a student, or if you are working as a teacher, you might have read it for preparing your classes and so on. Now in this textbook, we are going to have different chapters, right? So what are these chapters about? So basically like say the first chapter, usually if it's like say marketing, it's introduction to marketing. So in that we have the basic concepts, the definitions and so on. Then comes the second topic, like say it talks about your consumers, it talks about let's say it may talk about the marketing strategies, it may talk about pricing, it may talk about consumer behavior, right? So it may talk about the promotions. So likewise, we are going to have the chapter scheme. So different textbooks, they will adopt different chapter schemes, but then moreover, it's going to be almost similar in if you take standard marketing textbooks. Now from this list of chapters, that is referring to a good, when I say a good marketing textbook, it's going to be the best actually. It's not just a good, it's going to be the best, and more preferably it's going to be an international edition, not something which has been written by a local author, or maybe not something like a guide or some small lecture notes which we usually use for preparing the examinations at the end or and all. So we have to be going to a thorough or maybe a well-designed textbook. So from this list of topics which is written over here, so just it's an illustrative list, figure out which is the area which appeals you the most. So when I say which appeals you the most, it means that find out the area which you like teaching more or reading more about. So for me, if I take, it is the consumer behavior which is of more interest for me. I just enjoy teaching this particular topic and it's maybe more close to my heart, and somewhere I feel that I should explore this topic more and in detail. And therefore, this is what I would like to focus upon for my research. So what is happening is that from marketing, we have narrowed down to the subtopic, and that is consumer behavior. Now what next? So the next phase is going to be again interesting. So I have now narrowed it down to consumer behavior. So now the next step is that you have to go for a specialized book on consumer behavior. Like say you have good authors, like say you have Solomon, so which is a very, it's a standard textbook on consumer behavior. So maybe I should go on this particular textbook, I should read this textbook thoroughly, and then again within that maybe I have the different schemes, the chapter schemes, like say it talks about consumer attitude, it talks about consumer perceptions, okay, there could be some topics on IT in consumer behavior. There could be a topic on like say the consumer ethics and so on, right? So usually the first two chapters is like say introduction, and it could be consumer decision making process, okay? So somewhere like which is more general, there could be some topic on consumer product adoption and innovation. Okay, so if you are from this area, you would be aware about these topics, because this is what your area is. Similarly, for the students or maybe for the researchers who want to conduct this study in the field of like say human resources, right? So for them also the same procedure they're going to follow. So first of all, they should take a standard book on human resource management. Okay, then within that there will be some scheme of chapters referring to a good textbook. So it could be like, again, the first topic is going to be introduction, then we have something like say recruitment, selection, manpower planning, then we have performance appraisal, then we have training, then we have counseling, right? So we have human management skills, so something like say we have some scheme. So you have to figure out which is that area which appeals to you more. So basically the purpose over here is to more of streamlining, so that we are going to narrow down this entire process to figure out what is that we are interested in. So then okay, so from over here the list of topics, maybe this is what appeals me the most, the consumer perceptions. So I like teaching more about consumer perceptions. I like reading the theories about the consumer perceptions. I write like say exploring the research work on the consumer perceptions. So this is more, again, like say more close to my heart. It's like say I enjoy it more. So therefore, I am further reducing down this topic of consumer behavior to consumer perceptions. Okay. So perceptions basically is like say what the consumer thinks about. So it's his feelings, it's his beliefs that's coming from his own experiences, or that's coming maybe from the experiences of others, right? So it is just a perception. He might have experienced himself, or maybe he has learned it from others, or he might have read it from some different sources, he might have listened it from different sources. So that is what is going to be the theory of consumer perceptions, the basic definition of consumer perceptions. Now we are moving ahead. So slowly you see we are trying to narrow down the topic and you see from marketing we have narrowed down to consumer behavior, and from consumer behavior now we have narrowed down to perceptions, sorry, the consumer perceptions. Now what next? So now is there any another book available on consumer perceptions? If yes, you have to read it. If no, there is no textbook available, then what to do? Okay, then that's going to be a question mark. So if no textbooks available, then what are the different sources from where we will be looking the information on the consumer perceptions? So now for me, if I'm not getting any textbooks, I would look it on Google. I will visit some libraries for some written material, secondary information available to me on the literature of consumer perceptions, or maybe I go to IIT Bombay, or maybe I go to IIM Ahmedabad, I go to IIM Bangalore, I visit the physical libraries and then just try to get more information and more knowledge about the consumer perceptions. Because at my place, it is just limited. I don't have any another, or maybe I don't have more sources from my side. I have exhausted all my sources. But then, these things are going to be, or maybe the effort what is required over here, are going to be on a very higher side. And thanks to the digital technologies, that these efforts has been reduced to a high extent with the help of online libraries or the online research databases. So you might have heard about the databases like Scopus, you might heard about the databases like Web of Science, right? You might have even heard about one software that is called as Publish and Perish. Okay, so now when I talk about Scopus and Web of Science. Scopus and Web of Science, these two are the research databases, but these are the paid research databases. It is not coming for free. So for that, your institute or you can have the membership, but then it's going to be very expensive. So not many institutes effort to go with the Scopus or the Web of Science databases. But then the good thing is that many bigger institutions like IIT or IIMs and all, they have the subscriptions to these databases, and always you can approach the librarians over there in the universities or the institutes, and you can get the access as per the terms and conditions or the regulations of those universities. But most of the librarians, they would be encouraging the researchers coming to the library and availing the services. So they will be giving you the guest user login passwords, and they will be supporting you for your research. But if that seems to be difficult for you in the short run, this is what is going to really help you. So this is a software called as by the name Publish and Perish. Now Publish and Perish is basically linked with your Google Scholar. Okay, and this is a very small software. It's 1.5 MB software. It will just hardly take. It's for free. It is going to take you some 5 to 10 seconds to download and to use it for research purpose. And how to use it? I have already made a different separate video on this, and that video also I'll be sharing with you, and that you can see it separately and see how it's going to be useful for you for your research. Okay, so you can watch, you can go through that particular video which is sent as a separate attachment. So I'm not discussing about how to use the Publish and Perish over here, because that is going to take more time, and it will just disturb a flow of discussion. Okay, so when I'm going to use those research databases, either it's going to be Scopus or Web of Science, or it's going to be the Perish or Publish, I'm going to use the keyword as consumer perception. Now mind that this keyword consumer perception, no doubt to some extent we have narrowed it down, but still it is a very broad keyword. Right? Why I am saying that it's a very broad keyword? It's because when you are going to use this keyword in either of the previous research databases, Scopus, Web of Science or others, when you are going to give a search command for this, maybe that's my guess, that it will surely be generating around 5000 or more, if it's going to be more than 5000 research articles. Okay, so it is going to be generating more than 5000 research articles. Now what does this mean? Now it means that this concept of consumer perceptions has been studied a lot to a higher extent. Now what does it mean that we should not do the research in this area? No, it doesn't mean that. It means that there's a lot of work for you to do. In the sense, like say, what work? So it means that when I'm saying it's 5000 articles, so it means that, like say, a lot of work to do from your side in terms of filtering out the articles which are not of much interest to you. Now how do I filter these articles? Or maybe what I can suggest over here is that maybe you can focus just on the articles which have been published post 2015. Now if this is done, which is used as a filter, then I am going to focus only on articles which have been published post 2015. There is high chances that this figure of 5000 that may reduce down to, like say, around 2500. Okay, then there's some other filters available, right? So what are those other filters? Like it could be you can say I want only the academic research articles. When, like say, when I'm saying 5000, it's not research articles, it's all type of articles, which includes your research articles, it includes your trade articles, it includes your newspaper articles and all. Okay, but then when I'm going to give a filter on over these 2500 articles, that from these 2005 articles, I just would like to use only the academic articles. It might happen that your figures may drop to 1000. Now, this is a process of narrowing down your study. Okay. Now, 1000 also is a huge number, because you are just moving with a very broad term. As I told you earlier, you are focusing on what? The consumer perceptions. Now, I am somewhere stuck. In the sense, like, say, I don't know how do I proceed further, because I just can't move with these 1000 articles. I can't read all these 1000 articles, because it's going to be a lot of time consuming, and it's also going to be, like, say, requiring, like, how I would be able to concentrate on some few aspects. Okay, so what I suggest is that when you have these 1000 articles, okay, there is no need for you to download all these 1000 articles. What I suggest is that for all these 1000 articles, you just go through the titles of these articles. Okay, so what I'm saying over here is that you go through the title of these 1000 articles. Now, when you're going to go through the titles of these articles, so from the titles you will be coming to know about what exactly this article is trying to do. So in a sense, like, say, one article talks about consumer perceptions on online retailing. So now you get a feel what is there inside this article. So this article is talking about what? It's talking about the online retailing and how the consumers perceive this online retailing. Then there would be some article, like, say, talking about consumer perceptions and satisfaction in mobile industry. So mobile phone industry, right? So now, looking at the title, you come to know what this article is talking about, right? So likewise, you have to just go through the articles. Maybe if you start just going through the first 100 articles, you will get to know the type of studies which have been conducted or which are being conducted in this particular domain of consumer perception. So while going through this list of articles, the titles basically, suddenly I come across some very interesting titles, some very interesting topics. Like, the interesting topic what I have come across would be, like, say, the consumer perception towards the foreign brands or products. And maybe some topics like consumer perceptions on the country of origin. So it could be brands or products, or it could be like something consumer perceptions on imported products, and it talks about a comparison of Japanese and US products. Now, this is something which has caught my attention. So it talks about foreign brands, it talks about the imported brands, and it is talking about the comparative studies between different countries of origin and so on. Okay, so this has caught my attention, and I somehow get a feel from within that maybe I should pursue this topic of
research.
Now, there could be different reasons for this, like say why it has appealed me. Okay, so one possible reason could be like say recently a prime minister coming on the television and then he talking about Atmanirbhar, right? Now, what is this Atmanirbhar? He is talking about the local products and developing the local brands. Now, this is somewhere I feel maybe has initiated that interest on this particular topic, and maybe this is something which is catching my attention. I feel that, okay, in the present context of coronavirus or COVID-19, this is something, a topic which I should be able to pursue, because I feel that tomorrow most of the Indian companies would like to compete with the global brands. They would like to avail the schemes announced by the government in becoming local leaders. And I feel somehow that tomorrow the consumption is going to be more of the local products. So there has to be some studies, there are some investigations which are required or would be required by these companies to take their local strategies forward. And maybe it could be me who will be able to help them by conducting some investigations and providing some utility for them out of my study. So this is how it has to be linked. Okay, there has to be a connect between what you want to do, what has been already done, and how your work is going to be useful for the others. Okay, so the past literature, okay, and the present and the future context, this all has to be integrated together, and then that should lead to your study. So that makes your study highly relevant. Now what next? Okay, so now somehow while doing all these particular investigations, something has clicked in my mind, okay, that this is what it is going to be my research topic. Okay, so even before reading the new articles, or maybe the articles, the 1,000 articles which I have downloaded, right, on the consumer perceptions, these articles, the reviewing the titles has helped me to come out with some direction. So I would like to now move into that particular direction. So now what I am going to do is that when I have reduced or narrowed down my previous search from 5000 to 2500, from 2000 to 1000, now I want to further narrow it down. And what I am going to see, so already these 1000 papers are going to include the term consumer perception. Okay, now what I will do is that from these 1000 papers, I will further add the next filters. Now these next filters are going to be consumer behavior perception should be the keyword, along with that keyword, and the another keyword which we should be going with this consumer perception is the studies covering country of origin, okay, or it should have the term foreign, or it should have the term imported. And now I apply the filter. Now with these new filters, what will happen? These 1000 numbers will further reduce, and that will reduce down to a very low number, say an assumption, because you are not having the resources right now, because this video recording I am just doing with a lot of constraints, otherwise I would have surely shown the resources to you and how it should be done electronically. So usually when I take the workshops physically, that's face to face, so I demonstrate all these things by performing all these activities on the laptop. Okay, but then we have some constraints over here, so we can't do that. but then these additional filters maybe will lead to around 180 to 200 research papers. Now, which I feel is going to be really manageable. So now what do you mean by manageable? So manageable means that you have to download all these papers. So if you are going to download 180 papers, so it is going to take you maybe 1 to 2 weeks of time. Okay, so now once you have downloaded this paper, what next? So we'll move on to the what next part. So the next part, you are going to read the abstracts of these papers. Now you have around 180 papers or 200 papers, and abstract, if you see abstract, even if you are not having the full downloads of the paper, even then the access to the abstracts is given by the journals. If even the journal paper is not free for you still can access the abstracts. Now in abstract, what is the content available to you? In abstract, you will come to know the objective of the study, right? You will come to know the methodology that has been adopted by the authors in that study. You will come to know about the findings of the study, and you will come to know about if any implications given. So this is optional. Implications might be a part of those abstracts, it may not be a part of those abstract. Okay, so you just keep it aside, these implications. But then these three components, like objectives, methodology and findings, are always going to be there in any abstract of any journal. Okay, because these are the key contents of an abstract. Now reading the abstract, you will come to know about what the study is all about. So basically, from the objectives, you will come to know about what the study is all about. You have to take a call whether this really falls in the area in which you are interested. Now, when I say in the area in which you are interested, so what is the area which you are looking for right now? You are looking in the area of consumer perceptions and the foreign brands or the imported brands or the products. That is what you are trying to look, right? But then out of these 200 papers or 180 papers, it might happen that after reading the abstracts, you may find that in few of the papers, the country of origin or the foreign product or the imported product was just used as a reference. It is not a key component of that particular research paper. It is possible, right? Because like say for example, I develop a paper on supply chain, and somewhere in some context, I just mentioned that blockchain is required to be used for efficiency. So the term blockchain was used in that particular paper, but then the paper was more a discussion on the industry for technologies and not the blockchain technology. So it was just a reference. So likewise, there will be many papers wherein just the reference would be given, but that paper is not discussing much about those concepts. So it is possible that out of 180 or the 200 papers what you have narrowed it down, it is possible that only 120 papers are really speaking about the consumer perceptions and the foreign or the imported brands. Okay, so what's happening over here? We have narrowed down the papers to a great extent. So if you see from marketing to consumer behavior, to consumer perceptions, to consumer perceptions and foreign brands or products. So in this journey, we have traversed a long path, starting from textbooks,
to journal papers, and then finally to specific papers on the consumer perceptions and the foreign brands relationship. Okay, so now the next step is very interesting, because whatever we have done till now, it is not literature review. Okay, so right now until this stage, what we have done is that we have just prepared for the literature review. Now, of those 120 papers that has been shortlisted, we are going to review these papers in detail, in depth. So let's see how I'm going to proceed with this literature review. So what I suggest is that whenever you're going to do the literature review, you should maintain a book. So this is in all my workshops, I tell my my scholars, my research participants, that to maintain a book for their records. So so this is a A4 size book, and this is the two pages. Okay, the right hand side and the left hand side. So what you require to do is, so on the right hand page on the top, you are required to write the reference, the complete reference of that paper. Now, complete reference of that paper is like, say, Kamle, SS, the paper was published in 2010, the title of the paper, the journal name, the volume number, issue number, and page number. Okay, so this is what is referred to as my reference. Now over here, for that particular paper, you write the abstract. Now what is abstract? So abstract is basically, I use the term abstract. So no, it's not abstract, you write the review. Okay, so usually the way we write the review is more like, we first write the author name, or is the author surname basically. If there are two authors, we write the surname of both the authors. If there are more than two authors, we write the surname of the first author, and then et al, that's and others, and then the year. Okay, and then we write the objective of the study or the purpose of the study. We write the method they have adopted, and then we write the findings, right? So it's just more like a fill in the blanks, and I always repeat it, this can be done by anyone. For this, you need not happen to be a research scholar. Okay, even maybe my son, who is studying in, now he's in 12th, so he can also write it. If I just give him a paper and if I ask him to read just the abstract of the paper, and then fill in the blanks like author, author surname, the year, objective, method, and findings, because this is was something which is already available in the research paper. So I'll just write on sample abstract for you, so that gives us a feel. Sorry, I'm mistakenly using the term abstract. It's not abstract. The review for you. Okay. So Kamli, that's my surname. And Shaha is the next author. So they studied in the year 2019. Okay, what they studied? They studied the consumer perceptions on foreign brands. Okay, so now this is the objective. And further, the objective gives more details on what exactly they studied. So consumer perceptions on foreign brands using the factors price, quality, availability, warranty claims. Okay, now next, so this is the surname, the year,
your objective, now the findings. They found that, so I'm just, space is limited, so I'm not writing it, I'm just talking about that. So they found that quality and warranty claims, okay, are the most important attributes considered by the customers while they go for purchasing the foreign brands. So this is my finding. So what is the finding? That quality and warranty claims are most important. Okay, this is the finding. But I missed one more point, and that is the methodology. So what is the methodology of this finding, of the study? So the study was conducted on 250 engineering students in Bangalore. Okay, so I repeat once again. So it's a study conducted by Kamla and Shah in the year 2019 on studying the consumer perceptions on the foreign brands. The factors what they used were price, quality, availability, warranty and claims. The study was conducted on 250 engineering students in Bangalore, and they found that the students gave importance to quality and warranty claims while preferring the foreign brands over the local brands. Now this is what a review we talk about, right? Usually this is what we call it's a review. Okay, but then still I would like to say that this is incomplete. This is not a complete review, because here what I have done is just fill in the blanks. Author, written, year, written, objective, written. So as I told you, anyone can do this, right? Just to extract from the research papers and just put it over here. Then what's your role as a researcher? Okay, so now your role comes over here. Okay, so your role is going to be coming over here on the left hand side of this book, which you are going to maintain for each of the research papers. Okay, all the research papers, the similar reviews you are going to write in that notebook. So here, what on the left hand side, what you are going to write is going to be your views. So basically, what you can say is that, like on this left hand side, you have to write how you can take this study further. In what way you can develop this study further. If you want to do the same type of study, in what way you would like to proceed further. Okay, the simple things on which you can proceed further, or maybe you can bring in more contributions, is going to be in terms of, okay, this study was done in Bangalore. So now you can say that, okay, I would like to do it on the major metro cities of India. So that is like, say it will capture Mumbai, Bangalore, Delhi, Chennai and Kolkata. Okay, so this way you are contributing. This was just done in Bangalore. This study you would like to capture all the metros, because who knows, the views may differ across the cities, across the metros. Second, this study was done on whom? The engineering students, yes. But the question is that, why only on the engineering students? Why not the others? If it were the other students, like say the management students, the MBA students, will the views be different? We don't know, right? Why students? Why should not we focus on the professionals, the working professionals? Why we should not focus on the housewives? Why we should not focus on the other status, like say, why not on the businessmen, right? So there are a lot of things which we can bring in over here, okay? And both these changes, what I'm talking about, okay? So basically, I have raised some questions, like why only Bangalore? Why only
engineering students. Similarly, I can talk about, okay, so this is more focused on the methodology part, but then I can also talk about these factors. Price is there, quality is there, availability is there, and warranty claim is there. Is there something which is missing? Might be, yes. So like what is missing could be the brand image. What could be missing is the country of origin. Like if it's a US product, a mobile, a US product, I may prefer it as compared to a mobile which is coming from China. So that is what is the country of origin. The brand image, I would always prefer an iPhone over maybe a Lenovo or a Nokia. So that is the brand image. So likewise, so this is something which is not coming out of my knowledge. This is coming based on the earlier efforts what I have put in. Like while I have narrowed down the topics. And you know that already I have gone through thousands of papers, which has been narrowed down to 200 or 180 papers. And from there it has been narrowed down to how much? Around 120 papers, which I am presently reviewing. So that what happens is that in doing so, it is going to develop your knowledge. It is going to increase the knowledge base. And from that knowledge base, these are the factors which is going to be evolving. Right? So it's not that something which has come out of your mind. It is there in the literature. But then in a specific study, which right now we are reviewing, it is not there. So I'm just making a point over there that this is what something was not covered. And maybe if given a chance, I would like to include, or maybe I would like to work upon these gaps. Okay, I have used the term gaps. Okay. So basically, this is how we are going to come out with the research gaps. Now this is just a demonstration or illustration which I have shown for one paper. Okay, right now at present with you have 120 papers. This exercise you will be required to do for all the 120 papers. Okay, one more point. When this study is conducted, this study has been conducted on some specific product. Might be they have conducted this study on mobile phones. Okay, so now you can pitch in over here that why mobile phones? Why not some other product? Okay, what could be the most relevant product in today's time? Okay, so that questions has to be raised, and then whenever you're going to select or propose any product over here, that has to be given some proper backup to show that, okay, the study is relevant and studying that product and the perceptions of the consumers on that product with reference to the localization or the globalization of the brands, that needs to be investigated. So that is going to be bringing in more interest of others. Okay, if it's more relevant, it is going to be more interesting, and others will be more interested to read your study and would be like say very much excited to see your findings. Okay, so this is just a small demonstration within the available stipulated time on how we can come out with the research gaps. Okay, so now this exercise has to be performed just not for one paper. On the next page, on the two sides, you are going to review the second paper, the third paper, the fourth paper, and here are the gaps which you are going to keep on writing. Okay, so this is the hard work which you have done. This is time consuming, but then if done, if done, no one can stop you completing the research. Okay, because your foundation is ekdam strong. I know that the topic assigned to me is testing of hypothesis. Okay? I have not forgotten that, but then this is what the foundation is going to lead us to frame good hypothesis.
Without this knowledge, you can't develop the hypothesis. Okay, so we are slowly moving over there. We still have 10-15 minutes of time, and now we are proceeding towards our topic. But then before that, we have to come out with the objectives, because before framing the hypothesis, it's the objectives which is very important to be framed. Okay, so the hypothesis is an outcome of your objectives. Okay, so now the research gaps. Now for 120 papers, you have done the review. Agreed? And just we have done in this particular presentation, we have just done it for one paper. But then even if you see for that one paper, how many gaps we had? We almost had some 4 gaps. Right? So you can imagine for 120 papers, how many research areas or gaps we would be having to work upon. Okay, few of them would be duplicates, similar, like some maybe out of these 120 papers, many would have been done on the mobile phones, or the factors could be similar, but someone might have done it for the engineering students, someone might have done it for the management students, someone might have done it for the professionals, and XYZ. Okay, so now from our study, what we have got is maybe if I just consolidate the 120 papers. Okay, so this is something which is descriptive in nature. I am consolidating all this, so maybe I have around on an average 2 gaps per paper, so I will be having roughly around 240 gaps now. Okay, so I am just trying to consolidate it for 120 papers on different lines. So maybe on the sample, I'll just take it over here, this side. On the sample, how many studies are done on students out of 120? 80 studies has been done on students out of 120. How many studies has been done on businessmen? So just 10 studies done on businessmen. How many studies has been done on the professionals? And 80-90, so remaining 30 studies has been done on the professionals, right? So this is what has been the analysis of my research gaps. So basically it's a consolidation. Now similarly, on the variables, so quality, how many studies has taken quality as the factor out of 120? 80 studies. How many studies has taken country of origin? So 20 studies has only taken country of origin. How many studies they have taken the price? So almost all the studies, 120 studies, they have considered price. Okay, so likewise you have to do this particular analysis. Then what I come to know, okay, the products. How many studies they have done or studies on the mobile phones? So mobile phones 70%. How many studies they have done on the white goods? So white goods in the sense like the AC, the refrigerators, the ovens and something like that. So maybe around 30 studies they have done on. Okay, how many studies they have done on some other product, like say the watches, smart watches? So just 5 studies. Okay, and remaining 15 studies is on others, or we can say miscellaneous. So this is what we get. Then coming on to the cities, okay, the metros. So how many studies in Bangalore, how many studies in Mumbai, how many studies in only the metros, how many studies in Chennai, how many studies in tier 2 cities, and something like this. Okay, so I'll come to know that Mumbai, Bangalore, metros, so almost 100 of the studies out of 120 have been conducted, whereas only around 20 studies has been conducted in the second tier cities. Now this is basically an analysis which is required to be done by all of us, because this is what something is going to provide you with the real research gaps. Now if you want to do the study, what would be your selection out of this analysis what I have done? Okay, so it's very much clear for me. I would not like to go with more of student studies because a lot of work has been done on it. Businessman profession, just 40 studies in between them, very few on businessmen, professionals also very few. Okay, so this is something which is interesting. So which one I should select, businessmen or professionals? Okay, so it would be interesting for me to not focus just on one, but then it would be very much interested to me on doing a comparative study. So I can provide or I can plan for a comparative study between the businessmen and the professionals. Products. I should do mobile phone? No, I should not do mobile phone. Should I do white goods? To some extent, yes, there's a scope. Watches, fine. Miscellaneous, the remaining, right? So, because you want to position your study in the context of COVID-19, so post-COVID-19 study, right? So maybe you have to select something, some product, okay, which really is going to make an impact, some relevance, okay? So now what could be that particular product? So now for that you have to think, okay? It will not happen immediately. So for that you have to read the literature on the COVID-19. You have to read the literature more on, like, say, which are the type of products which presently we are importing a lot from outside. We have a lot of reliance on the imports. So we have to study those products because that is what in future I would like to be manufacturing in India. Okay. So I want to build my capability. So select some products like those which really is going to be having an impact on a post-COVID period. So now similarly, factors. So quality has been used many, country of origin 20. So likewise, I find that reviewing all the 120 papers, I come across some 15 factors. Okay, but then not all the papers have used all these 15 factors. In some paper they have used 5 factors, in some papers they have used 7 factors, in some papers they have used only 8 factors, in some papers they have used 12 factors. But then when I see the literature, when I see 120 papers, I come to know that there are 15 different types of factors on which we can evaluate the consumer perceptions. So now my study will consider all these 15 factors. Now coming over here, whether it should cover the metros? No, a lot of study has been done. Maybe I should focus more on the second tier cities because these are also an important customers and they have a lot of share in my in the product sales, right? Because and like say with this digital transformation and all, it's like say we don't have now the boundaries like Amazon, we have Flipkart. Now everyone is delivering the products anywhere, right? Everywhere and anywhere. Everywhere to anyone. So now this is how I am going to do the analysis to arrive at my objective, or in a sense, like say, what I can say is that the research gaps are going to help me to develop my research objectives. So the research gaps are going to be my research objectives. Be clear, the research gaps are going to be now developed such that it is going to become the research objectives. Now research objective, okay, so this research gaps has to be framed as a research objective. So research objectives are nowadays the fashion is like say we put it more like a research question. Okay, so like see if I just put it over here, the research question number one, right? What
are the significant factors considered by the while selecting foreign banks. So I know that there are 15 factors, but then out of these 15, which are the significant? Okay, and this study which we have already decided the product. I'm not discussing it over here, but then when I'm going to conduct this study, it is for a specific product. Second, this study we know that it is a computer study between the businessman and the professionals. So the next research question is going to be, does the consumer perceptions on the above factors, these 15 factors, differ between businessmen and professionals? So what's the research question? Second research question. So this is one, this first research question is that these are the important factors when it comes to the product. So it's in general. Second research question is that I want to know whether the businessmen and the professionals, they perceive it equally or they give varying level of importance. Like say, is it that a businessman says that the price is very important while selecting a foreign brand, it should be low priced, or the professional says that okay, the price should be more. Price is not a concern. He is able to pay any amount of money. So that is what we are trying to investigate with this study. Okay. So now this is about research questions. The same research questions are nothing but can be also framed as a research objective 1, research objective 2. So when I'm going to frame it as objectives, it should not look like a question, it should look like a investigation. Okay, what you want to do. So instead of what are the significant factors, the study would be to evaluate the significant factors considered by the customers. Okay. Thus the consumer, so it should not like question, it should be actionable to evaluate the consumer perceptions of the above factor. Okay. To evaluate the differences between the consumer perceptions of businessmen and professionals on the above factors. Okay, so just the style of writing is going to change. Otherwise, research question and research objectives are same. There is no difference between these two. Okay, so now this is what is a research objective. But the next point, so this is now going to be a concluding phase, wherein now I am trying to introduce, or I will be bringing in the hypothesis component. Okay, so now it is going to be very interesting to understand how this hypothesis is going to be coming in the field of social sciences. In statistics, you might have studied hypothesis in different way. Like we have H0, we have H1, there is null hypothesis, there is alternate hypothesis and so on. Okay, but in social sciences, that's not the way we are going to write the hypothesis statistically. In social sciences, the hypothesis is going to be linked with your research objectives. Okay, and how that is going to be linked, just pay attention over here. This is very, very important for you now. Okay, this study, or not this study, this objective, the first objective, it's not that that it has been not studied before. It was studied in different context,
we had 120 papers, right? But only thing was that not all the papers had covered all the 15 factors. As I told you, few papers had 5 factors, few papers had 6 factors, few papers had 10 factors. But now this is the first paper which is capturing lot of new factors, okay, which is coming out to be 15. So it means that previously also this type of objectives were there, but then they were different. Okay, the objective what I have developed is more exhaustive in terms of capturing all the different types of factors. Now there are 120 papers. Okay, now we had written before that out of that 120 papers, price was covered almost in all the papers, 120 papers. Quality was covered in almost like say 80 papers and so on. Yes? Yeah. So it was covered. So now just pay attention over here. If you recollect, I had asked you to write the review in the book. Okay, the right hand side and the left hand side, if you remember. Yeah, you remember it now. So I had asked you to write over here the review, the surname of the author, the year, the objective, the methodology, and the findings. The objective we used to identify the research gap. Okay, like for example, one study used only cost and quality. So the gap was, why not country of origin considered, something like that. So that was linked to your objective. On the methodology part, this also helped us to develop the research gaps. The study was conducted, if you remember, on the engineering students. We raised a question, why not on the professionals, why not on the housewives, why not on the businessmen and so on. So it was useful for us. The previous studies was done only in the metros. Most of the studies, almost 80% of the studies were done in the metros. So why not in the second tier cities? So these two objectives and methodology we have already used, and that was already worked upon to develop the research gaps. But now, what are the findings? Findings also were the part of the study, but in findings we had not used, right? So now just for one paper, we already have mentioned the finding we had written, and the finding was price and, sorry, not price, it was quality. Quality and country of origin was found to be the most important factors, right? So this one study, quality and country of origin were found to be the most important factors. So that's the finding. We have noted it down, but we have not yet used. So likewise, what we can do is that we know that the first objective, this is research objective 2, the first research objective 2, which are the most important factors when it comes to purchasing the foreign brands. So see in those 120 papers, what is the trend of the finding? And if I see the trend, I find that the quality, country of origin, and warranty claims. These three factors were the highly observed findings in the previous studies. No doubt the previous study was done for mobile phones, the previous study was done for XYZ products. We are not concerned about where the previous study was done. We are not concerned about on which products the previous study was done. We are just concerned about the variables which we have used in the objectives, that is this, and what was the outcome. So here the outcome is the quality, country of origin, and the warranty claims is usually seen to be the top factors while selecting a foreign brand. So this is based as per the consumer perceptions. Okay, these are the consumer perceptions. Now,
this happens, this finding, because this is a trend, this finding is a trend in my 120 papers.
So out of 120 papers, almost 50-60 papers have given the same type of findings.
Okay, so this is why I said that hypothesis is going to be linked with your objectives, which in turn is going to be linked with your literature or review. So my first hypothesis is that quality, country of origin, and the other one was what? Warranty claims are the most significant factors as per consumer perceptions.
Okay, so this is how I am going to come up with hypothesis number one. Likewise, now I take objective number two to evaluate the consumer. So to evaluate the differences between the consumer perceptions between two groups on those factors, that two groups are professionals and the businessmen.
Okay. So I have to see the previous studies again. So now might be the previous studies has been done separately. As we have already seen, 30 studies were done on the professionals and 10 studies were done on the businessmen. Okay. Now, in 30 studies, based on the 30 studies, the trend what I got to know is that professionals give importance to quality and the service availability, whereas businessmen, they give importance to price. So what is happening now? The difference in the findings, professionals, they give importance to service availability and the quality, whereas businessmen, they give importance to what? The price. So it means that there is a difference in their opinions. Now this trend I am going to capture, and that is going to help me to develop my second research hypothesis. And that second research hypothesis is that the perceptions, the perceptions of professionals and businessmen differ.
So this is how I have come up with the two research hypotheses, which now I will be required to test. And now for testing, that requires some statistics. Okay, and statistics using SPSS, I believe, is going to be some other session for you, which is going to be handled by some other professor. But then what the hypothesis we have written right now, it is in subjective language. So while you are going to test this hypothesis, you have to make it numerical so that it matches with your statistical requirements. Like say, for example, the perceptions of the professionals and the businessmen differ. Okay, so it means that there are two groups. The first group is professionals, the second group is the businessmen. So it is mu of professionals and mu of businessmen. Now what it is saying? It differs. The perceptions of professionals and businessmen, it differs. Differs means it is not equal. They are different. So mu p is not equal to mu b. This is how this hypothesis is going to be written. And now, as per statistical terms, this is your H1, that is the alternate hypothesis. And what will be the null hypothesis? The null hypothesis will be mu p is equal to mu b. It means their perceptions are same. Their perceptions are different.
So this is what is a hypothesis. The subject to hypothesis, now we have changed it to your true sample. T-test would be required to evaluate this particular hypothesis. Okay. Likewise over here, quality. Okay, so quality, and then this is country of origin and warranty are the preferred factors. Likewise for that, we are going to use the one sample t-test, okay, on these different factors, and we will be testing the hypothesis. So for you to now proceed further, you will be required to have the knowledge on how these statistically hypotheses are going to be tested, for which there are many softwares available with us, like SPSS not, and maybe sometime later I will be spending time with you people, and maybe I can help you on, like say, educating on also how to test this hypothesis in much more simpler way. That's just the way we have discussed in today's session. Okay, so now I'll just in the next 5 minutes conclude this entire thing. Initially, what we did is that we had a broad topic that was on marketing. We narrowed it down to consumer perception. We did LR search. We narrowed it down to consumer perception and foreign products. Then we conducted a literature review, I say analysis. We found the gaps, and then we came out with the research objectives. And from the research objectives, we had two objectives. For each of the research objectives, we had a research hypothesis. Okay, so the research hypothesis is usually nothing but in the literature pertaining to your research objectives, what are the trend in the findings. Okay, so with this maybe we will cut it short, and I just wind it up. What I can do is that I can share with you my mobile number, so if you have any questions or if you need more clarity, you can call me or you can post me your queries. So this is my mobile number. I also share with you my personal email ID, sachinnitie06@gmail.com. Okay, so thank you to you. Thank you, and all the best.